Hi, good afternoon and welcome to dSPACE Innovation Coffee Break. My name is Bassam Abdelghani from the Strategic Product Management team here in dSPACE.
Hello, and I'm Carsten Krascher from the Engineering Services, where I'm a team leader responsible for data replay.
And today, we will walk you through our hardware validation suite for our perception and sensor fusion components based on our hardware test solutions. I'm glad that you joined us today, because I believe that in joining us today, we share a common vision, which is vision autonomy. We see that whether you look at it from the concept of freeing up the commuter time, or maybe unlocking the parking plots in the city center, or maybe from another view, which is generating new business model for based on the level 4 and 5 autonomy levels. This is a goal that we both share together. However, in achieving this goal, we have to overcome multiple challenges. We see that the complexity of the software components that should be or that will be on a platform, an autonomous driving platform, will go higher and higher. So as we see that some roles, maybe the perception and fusion, also the trajectory planning and so on, will be migrated from the typical driver part into the software itself, which then means that higher validation levels will be needed. So for example, the current perception and fusion components are not typically designed with the common model-based design approach that we have seen in the automotive world till now. They will be done in artificial intelligence, or maybe as directly written code in C++ or maybe other languages, which means that we need higher level of data or higher amount of data to validate these functions. And here we see the trend that the common automotive vehicle companies, or OEMs and tier ones, are migrating from typical engineering companies into IT companies. And this, of course, means that huge amount of data will have to be synthetically generated and also collected during test drives, which is okay. But what kind of challenges do I have when I have this amount of data? Well, taking a deeper look on that, we will see that the system under test or the device under test, which is on the vehicle itself, will have to be ingested with data not only during the test drive itself, but afterwards, which means that I'll have to collect petabytes of driven kilometers. There will be cameras included, there will be lidars and multiple sensors. And all of these data will have to be recorded and then replayed into the device under test in later phases, not in vehicle. This is okay. The challenge then comes in synchronizing these multiple data streams, which are heterogeneous in their nature and impose challenges in its synchronization. Maybe other challenges would be in the security stack that you are implementing on your device under test. So if you are maybe having a system under test that has secure IPsec calculation on it, you will have to recalculate these values, these security checks, plus adapt the time information during the replay process, which is quite challenging in real time. Moreover, you'll have to have a scalable system, which can be validated or controlled from a test automation or test management framework from the cloud or maybe from on-premise, and which can be able to handle the petabytes of data. All of these challenges have made us go into this direction and to offer you a comprehensive solution for hardware and software data replay validation. Today, we'll walk you through our hardware data replay validation, and maybe in the next session, we will talk into other validation data replay validation solutions. To overcome the mentioned challenges in for the hardware validation of the device under test, we have come up with a compact solution that enables you to test your sensor components, the smart sensors that generate object detection lists and so on, and also your ADAS AD platform, complex platform that does the sensor fusion for multiple sensors, and also the object recognition and the trajectory planning. And for that solution, I will hand over to my colleague, Carsten, who will show you in details how the construction works and which data is being transferred, and the demo in details.
Thank you. Okay, so here in our demo, what you can see, we have the device under test, which we have chosen an NVIDIA Drive AGX, which would be your device, of course, in your case. We have some interfaces. We have LVDS, GMSL camera interfaces. We have an automotive Ethernet interface here. And we have a CAN interface connected here. And yeah, to feed the data into the device, we use the environment sensor interface unit for the GMSL interfaces. You can find that here, the environment sensor interface unit connected using these coaxial cables to the GMSL interfaces. We have the dSPACE Scalexio system, which is responsible for handling the bus data for replaying, in this case, CAN data. You can find that down here. So this is the Scalexio system. You can see all the slots available here. We can add interface boards for multiple bus systems, whatever you need to adapt to your system. And what we need is a PC to actually read the data from your data storage, your data center, which you can find down here in this system. So what you don't see is, because it's hidden inside of the device, is the time synchronization, which is performed using PTP. So all the systems, the PC, the environment sensor interface unit, and the Scalexio system are all connected using a 1 gigabit Ethernet network to a time synchronization switch, which enables us to have a shared time between all the systems to have a really accurate replay time to synchronize your data. So on the replay PC, you can see we use RTMaps, and I will switch to RTMaps. And what you see here is we will play back two images, the left and the right image of a stereo camera. We will play back the position from the test drive, and we will play back the LiDAR point cloud. And all this will be fed using the Ethernet connections to the environment sensor interface unit for the raw sensor data, and to the Scalexio system for the bus data. So using these connections, the replay PC will provide the data to our interface units and to your device in that case. So when I start this diagram, it will actually start replaying our test drive. And then we can switch to this monitor, which is directly connected to the Drive AGX. And what you see here is we have the DriveNet camera example running down here, which is doing object detection. So it has not been modified. It is simply using it. It feels like it is really connected to the cameras. We also have a 3D viewer to visualize the point cloud data. We have a map instrument showing the position that we sent using a CAN message. And up here you can see the CAN messages that we sent, and the position and the velocity of the vehicle, which is decoded from the CAN message. And you can see everything is fed into the device under test in a synchronized manner. And the Drive AGX really feels like it's in the car. So Our data replay solution feeds all the data into the device under test, and the device under test will provide the results using maybe an automotive Ethernet output. And we can compare that against the ground truth that is required to measure how good your algorithms are. And our colleagues can help you with annotating your data.
Exactly. That being said, one single system of this architecture can validate up to multiple sensor components. Or you can look at it from otherwise. You can scale up these systems to have hundreds of it to validate an AD platform. We are totally scalable in this approach. Moreover, this is not our only data replay solution. We have also solutions for validation of software components in the early development phases. We have also solutions for test management, and all our systems can be installable on your premise data center or on a co-location data center for which we have multiple partners. That being said, I would like to thank you for joining this video, and if you have any question, we are open for answering. Thank you.
Okay, I can already see a first question, and the question is, if we have a solution for managing the data, for which data to replay, and how to handle that?
Yeah, for this regard, we have a solution. It's called IVS, in Tempora Validation Suite, and I would be glad to show you this solution in upcoming videos. However, in this time, it will be a little bit limited. But the solution generally is a cloud-based solution that manages recorded real-world data, and it can also select, or like you can browse the data out of it. You can select based on roundabout, maybe in during night or during a traffic position. And it's quite flexible to choose the data out of your data bank and to replay it and connect it with our replay solution, SIL software and hardware. I also see here a next question, which is talking about the data throughput that we are supporting. Here it says, what is the maximal data throughput that we reached till now, and whether we see potential for increasing this? Maybe you can take this
over. Yeah. As Bassam already pointed out, it is a really scalable solution. So we can adapt to the data rate you need. And we have already built systems for data rates up to 40 gigabit per second. So, but even higher data rates are not a problem because we have this scalable solution.
Exactly. So thanks again for joining us for this small video. And I hope that we will meet together, maybe virtually, maybe personally, soon. Thank you.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.